Today my pet project is Thomas Arne. Thomas Arne. Middle name Augustine. Thomas Arne, earlier part of the 18th century. I think he was born around 1710 or something like that. Anyway, I was very much taken by Arne's music a long time ago, having heard one of his concertos for keyboard instruments. Excuse me, I get a little comfortable. It's been a busy day. And at that time, I wanted to do one of the concertos, and the music was very difficult to locate. And when I did, it was difficult to put together because you couldn't buy the music. You had to rent it with a lot of red tape. The situation may still be the same. Anyway, Thomas Arne was extremely important in his day, which means he was a very successful composer of a lot of different kinds of music, stage music for Drury Lane Theatre and Covent Garden in London. He was influential to the music of Mozart, and who visited London and heard Arne's music. Arne was also one of the most Italianate of all the British composers. Italy invaded the artistic tastes of London back then. It was the rage. Handel himself had much to do with that. As his music demonstrates, the Italian also. The music I've managed to acquire on Imslip is available in an old handwritten score, and it has a great introduction by the editors. It is actually edited by Thurston Dart, no less. Anyway, the original, and it comes from the original, the ancient edition, which begins, "It is presumed that this great work, the celebrated concertos of Dr. Arne, at length presented to the musical world, will not disappoint the very high expectations which have been formed of its value. Those amateurs and professors who witnessed the astonishing effect of these concertos when they were so successfully performed under the masterly execution and direction of the doctor's son, the late Michael Arne." Michael Arne was his son, as it says here, also a musician. "They have never failed to bear the handsome testimony to their merits, and the impatience of these gentlemen to see them in print, that the fame of them might, by the recommendation, be duly extended, while it does infinite honor to their taste and liberality. claims the warmest gratitude of the publishers. And onward and onward. It could have been written by Leonard Stern himself. The mood and quality of the writing. I might get to the first concerto. I want to begin with some of the second sonata. He wrote about a lot of music. And of the keyboard pieces, I think something like six sonatas and maybe six concertos, something like that. The first time I heard the concertos, I thought it was hauntingly beautiful. Here's a sonata, 2-2. They can be played, according to Dr. Arne, on the harpsichord, the organ, or the piano forte. Voila. There's much to be said about Thomas Arne. Additionally, among these, his personal life, created some hardships, ups and downs in family fortunes and so forth. Educated at Eton when he was young, and at the best schools, in other words. And he was a Roman Catholic at a time when Roman Catholicism was not yet banned, and the difficulties with the Reformation, which it was about to have before long. But he liked Byrd, William Byrd, they were Romans. He was married. This is a kind of interesting anecdote. First marriage was dissolved because he claimed she was mad. And I don't know what happened to her. I believe she may have been committed. And was married a second time. That didn't work out too well. And she married a string player, violinist, or somebody named Pinto or Binto or something of the sort. And then I understand, according to internet, that he reconciled with his wife. Now, I don't know if that's the mad one or the one who married the Italian string player, but reconciliation is always nice to hear. What else can we say about Dr. Arne? Plenty, really. But let's want to replace some of the sonata. Number 2. It's interesting to call sonatas and concertos, but they often follow the organization of the suites, the minuets, and gavottes, and gym type things, and so on. This begins with a andante. Allegro and a minuet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thomas Arne. Someone really well worth knowing. He also wrote two famous pieces, Rule Britannia and A Hunting We Will Go. A Hunting We Will Go. Thank you.